up, YouTube? Back with another video, back with another reaction. As you all know, Ace Family dropped their actual documentary. It's a whole 30 minutes long, so I'm not gonna waste your time. But before we get started, I want to know if you're new and you've never seen me before, or if you're newer and you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you hit that subscribe button, make sure you hit that bell button, make sure you like this video, and we just get to it. I'm not going to screen record because I don't want to edit, so we're just gonna put Bear right here. And we can watch it at the same time. Can y'all see this? No? So, if you can't see this, I'm sorry, but just go to their channel and watch it, trending, watch it. It's all there for you, you know what I'm saying? I promise. Mommy, come on. Ella's so precious. I just watching her grow up and just like, it's kind of cool. Chubby baby. A million people in their lifetime, like 15 million to support you, that's dope. Let's get ready.
And just in case you missed it,
well, Ace Family, we're on to where everything starts.
A new car every day.
So, do you remember the truth in this spot?
Yeah, so remember when you went to college and I was gonna go move there with you and I had to like put my car somewhere? I had to like park my Jeep somewhere?
Yeah.
I didn't have anywhere to park it. So, you had a friend at the time that lived there.
Ryan.
I brought my car there,
yes.
Parked it for a couple of months, and when we moved back, we were staying at your dad's while we were looking for a place. And I reminded you, I was like, oh, I liked that place. I don't know what area that was in, but I liked it.
So we went there to, like, just to see possibilities. And come to find out, one of my good friends worked there.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Right? Awesome. And he ended up hooking us up with, was it a loft, right?
Yeah.
A loft for super cheap. So I think the loft was, like, $2,100, and I was telling him, like, to be honest with you, we don't really have the money for that. Is there anything you can do for us? And he was like, yeah, let me get back to you. And I think he gave it to us for like $1,500.
Oh, and I remember when you called me and you were like, the best part about it is we don't have to give them like first, last, and security. We just have to give them like the first month.
Yes. Like, yes.
That was why we were so excited to move in, because we didn't really have like all the money to be spending on that apartment.
On top of that, you were 8 months pregnant.
Ready to pop. Yeah,
so if it wasn't for him,
where would the home was in the car or something.
What was your guys' life like before all this started?
It was so, like, peaceful.
I was definitely more free. When I mean my free is I was able to go out
and be yourself
and not worry about anyone around me. I was able just to go, do what I had to do, come back to the house, not worry about anybody following me, not worry about anybody being at my house when I got there.
Not worry about getting dressed.
Not worrying about, you know, friends or acquaintances, people that I meet, wanting something from me. You do not understand how excited I am to be here. Damn, it has been 2 years since we've been here. Well, it seems longer because we've done so much, but...
Literally, we've done so freaking much that I don't even know, like, one day from another. I don't know what day we've
been here. I don't know where they are, but it's so
this
beautiful.
This spot is nice. Yeah, I'm a little nervous to see your old spot. It's gonna bring back so many memories.
It's just weird how different people exciting. Grow up. Like, this is normal.
So, we're obviously not going to be seeing... the same exact one that we were living in, but we're gonna see something very similar. Are you nervous?
No.
No?
To me, it's fun.
I'm a little nervous just because...
Catherine Savage with the braids.
And it's just crazy to like put yourself back in that same situation that we were in.
Memories pop up on it.
Wait. This is the same exact one.
Is it? Wait. Oh, yeah, no, it's not.
Same, like, setup, though.
Yeah, they don't look the same.
This one's, like, almost identical. So,
ours was, like, there in the corner.
Yeah, the only difference was ours was in the corner, and this one's over here. But same exact setup. So you guys are going to see exactly where everything started, right here in our first very apartment. Oh, come, 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 come. We were happy. I mean, we're still happy, but... We were so happy living in our 600 square foot apartment.
We were so happy.
You know, like, we didn't have to think about much.
Oh my god, yes, we did our laundry.
Look, just look at this. Just come in. Hey, Sam, we just come in.
I feel like we were just content.
We were content with where we were.
Yeah.
Okay. Our situation, we were in like a struggle, you know? Before that moment, we were living at my dad's house with you being pregnant, having a kid. When we first moved into this spot, we were unable to afford furniture for the first, I want to say 2 weeks. And Catherine and I bought a blow up mattress, air mattress, whatever you want to call it. We put it right here, right in the middle of our living room. So what we were doing,
I remember all the pranks at that house. Peace of man.
I mean, that was doing our best.
They ain't into the
lot. We barely got to that point. Starting this whole
journey,
we never thought we would get to this point. Mm-mm. Shall we go up to the master bedroom? Not really master, but
the only
bedroom. Let's first hit you guys with the bathroom.
Oh gosh, this.
So continue to the only bedroom.
Mm. Oh, it seems so much bigger before. You know what I just realized?
Like I got hella
space.
This
is crazy.
So now it's like tiny too.
So not only did we start what we do today, our lifestyle, and obviously become famous, but we also became parents at the very same time.
Yeah, what makes it that much harder?
I have this really distinctive memory of me and you coming upstairs when Ella was like 2 months old and us looking over and she was looking at us and I remember us saying, wow, I can't believe she can actually see us from up here.
She has really good eyesight.
Yeah, she has really good eyesight. She was smiling.
Maybe it was
something. Remember?
Yes.
I have like that really distinctive memory.
And one thing that we did love, obviously we loved this entire spot. This was our very first spot. We couldn't be more blessed to be able to have even a spot like this at the time. But I think the best thing about this exact apartment was how high the ceilings were and the windows.
Okay, so because of the high ceilings, in my mind, like I would always imagine in the future when I do have a house, when I do buy my own house, I want it to be high ceilings.
Yeah.
Because of this
place. Because of this place.
Yeah.
Damn. We're actually here.
Theodore.
Avalon. A place that we will always remember for the rest of our lives. Before we take you guys over to the next place that we lived in, the next apartment, I just want to say that when we moved out of here, we had 300,000 Ace family members. Just so you guys can understand our timeline of where we were during our YouTube career. But don't get me wrong, 300,000 subscribers is a lot.
Give me that today, I'll be.
But listen, we were taking risks in our lives as if we had more. Mm-hmm. And that's what it's about. Because we believed in us so much that we were taking leaps of faith. We were like jumping into things that we probably shouldn't have jumped into. But we did it because we believed in ourselves.
We are literally like the biggest risk takers. And you'll see why in the series. But
you'll see why we're risk takers. Let's continue. We didn't know what we were doing. Did we?
No, we didn't. We had the worst camera ever.
We had the worst quality camera.
I mean, at least we had a camera. But
yeah, I started my phone.
Yeah, it wasn't the best camera. And I believe our YouTube channel name was Austin and Catherine Vlog Start Now. It was not the Ace Family. We changed it to the Ace Family like 3 or 4 months after.
For those who do not know, or haven't noticed already, we changed our YouTube name to
the Ace Family.
The Ace Family.
I think our first intro was, hey guys.
Hey guys,
welcome to our YouTube channel.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. Once we moved into the second place, we decided, oh shit, we're really doing this. Because our rent's more expensive, so we gotta pay the bills.
Right.
And if we don't, then we're back at square one. But it didn't even matter because at that point, we had nothing to lose.
Yeah. Okay, so now we're headed to the second place that we lived in, which is our second apartment. This apartment, I believe, was 1,500 square feet. So double the size of our first apartment. And it was super expensive. What did we pay?
Oh, it's the one that had one on one side, one on another.
Anybody that lives in an apartment knows that that is ridiculous. And we didn't have the money at the time to just spend $3,500 a month on rent. So, you know what we did? We worked our asses off because we believed that we could make it happen. Let's just show you guys. All right, so before we walk in this apartment, I just want you guys to know, before we moved in here, Elle was around 6 months. The more Ace family members we had, the more it got a little crazy, because this is the place where people found out where we lived, and that's when the whole madness began.
Is this even the right key? That's not even the right key. We have issues.
There we go. Welcome. Once you walk in, the floor, show them the floor. People are going to be taking their shoes off whenever they come in. This is our lovely kitchen.
Hey, so fair warning, someone literally just moved out of this apartment, so that's why it's a little messy.
So this was our apartment, but like, in reverse.
In reverse, yes. All the appliances, everything you see was the exact same. The layout was just flipped. And this is it, guys.
Lost our engagement ring in the sink.
This was what we did. All of our
story times,
challenges. That's we used crazy. To do the open box videos, the P.O. box openings.
Yeah, we used to do it.
This is our living room. This is where all the family gatherings used to take place. This is where we did majority of our filming.
Here.
From the last place that you've seen.
Christian audience.
We obviously couldn't do much filming there because the place literally was too small. But this was much bigger and we were able to do so much more. Content leveled up. Bigger than the last spot.
Oh my gosh.
I used to love our bathroom.
I used to love this bathroom.
I love this bathroom. So my favorite part about this bathroom is actually the tub. And this is where I would give Elle all her baths. So I would put her in here.
So it was a beautiful place, but it was also starting to get scary because we started getting famous.
Yeah. And Elle was growing up. Because before, when Elle was a baby, there wasn't much for her to do other than just to be there.
Yeah. So when we moved in here, well, before we moved in here, we knew we couldn't afford it. We had just enough to pay for this place. And to be honest with you, it's like we really took a risk because we knew that moving into this place, that we would really be able to capitalize and make more videos and be more active and, you know, whatever. So we moved in here, and I remember the first day we moved in, we were like,
holy crap, we're gonna have to really film every single day.
Yeah. Once the money in the bank account was getting low, that's when we amped it up.
Come on, sis, pull through.
We amped it up so much that we had to start filming every other day. We knew that if we were consistent, we would continue to grow, we would grow even faster. Elle loves being in front of the camera. Like,
we started incorporating her more.
Yeah, but I feel like as she, you know, was growing up and she was so used to having the camera on her, it was almost like she was natural. She loved doing it. And I feel like that is such a huge asset to our channel because when
she's
you
cool
enjoy
with
something,
it.
It makes it that much better.
It makes it that much better and that much easier.
Yeah.
Like, if Elle didn't like being in front of the camera, if she was like...
Oh, we would not
like
be the
running,
Ace family.
Like, if she was running away and she wasn't, like, you know, interacting, we would not be the Ace family.
No, we wouldn't. 100%. So it would never be the same effect.
Yeah. It's this place.
And even kids nowadays, they grow up with tablets. They grow up with all that other stuff. Like, my generation was, like, the brink. Like, we had the Nokias with the snake on there. Like, we had barely had technology.
Years since we've been here.
Now they grow up and they know how to do it more than you do.
It's only been a freaking year.
And they 2 years old.
Yeah, think about it. It only has been a year.
It's crazy.
It's been a freaking year since we've been here. This is really where the Ace family was created.
Basically.
The Ace family brand was built here.
Yeah.
Because what do we, I think we hit 1 million.
Here.
We hit 1 million Ace family members here. And we were growing so much and so fast that we actually had a tourist attraction on our balcony.
Towards the end. Yeah.
Towards the end of us living here, we would literally have people outside our balcony yelling, "Hey, Ace fam, late." We would come home and people would be sitting there all day for us to come home.
At that point, we could no longer live in the last house.
Yeah.
It was, there
for,
was just no way.
For several reasons. One being, obviously, the fans were getting buck wild outside on the balcony.
Knocking on our door, ringing our doorbells a million times.
We just, it was almost impossible for us to film at that spot because of how loud the fans were outside. Like, they were yelling Ace Family as we were filming. So while we were filming, you would hear, "Ace Family, come out." Like, it was just too much.
Yeah.
So towards the end of our stay at the last home, we actually ended up leaving a couple of months early. I couldn't even, like, walk past my balcony because, like, people would just literally stand there throughout the entire day. And it was so...
And I like walking around as natural as possible,
support.
So...
But then at the same
I need blackout curtains.
Like, wow, we really do not have
sometimes act like when we're home. We're like, make sure we have no movement. Everybody staying below the windows.
I imagine like living like that. I mean, we obviously did, but it was like
it was crazy.
It was crazy.
It's not safe. It's not fun.
So we decided to move
to a home.
To a home.
We had no choice. At that point, you had no choice.
Yeah.
We can't go to another apartment.
Yeah. No. No.
And then we knew we were gonna grow.
But
we didn't know how much we were gonna grow. Because had we known, we would have moved into a gated place.
Yeah, and that was one of the biggest conversations we had moving into a home. Was it like, do we move into a gated community, or do we just move into a low key home with a gate in front of it? Are we safe that route? Because we were in that in between of like, we're big, but
we're still
able to be normal.
We were trying to find a home, and every single place we looked at that we actually liked, they, obviously you guys know, when you buy a home, you have to provide 2 years of taxes.
Which we did not have.
Which we didn't have, so you have to have 2 years of taxes of that amount of income.
Mm-hmm.
So we orchestrated our deal in where you can rent out for a year, and it's called like lease to buy, or rent to buy. And so you lease a place for a year and then you buy it and then the money that you spent to lease it goes into the home of purchase.
Correct. So we got lucky and moved into this place.
Oh my God, it was like my dream
a
house.
Trial
I love
man.
This house.
And so we did make that transition of moving into a low-key home with a gate in front.
At the very end of the street, at the very top of the mountain.
Very top of the mountain, last house on the cul-de-sac. Trying to picture it in my head of what we were thinking when we did it because thinking
what
back,
were you thinking?
It was the worst mistake we could have probably ever done. But like you said, you never know where you're going to end up. It was a great investment in our business.
Yeah.
Right?
I just feel like...
Did you feel that way?
Well, when we moved in, I was like, we're going to be here for a while. Like,
yeah.
We're going to be here for a while. In the next couple of years, we'll end up leaving.
But one thing about the house that I still to this day am obsessed with is the view.
Yes.
The view was unbelievable.
And I feel like the house was so nice that it motivated us to want more.
Wow. So this
they
is
backyard where, alone. I could live in the backyard. Give me like a tent.
Our lives.
It's hot out there. I ain't gotta worry about no cold, snow.
This house. The last apartment was where the Ace Family brand was created, like our niche and what we were gonna stand for. This but like this average. House
just, like, scared.
Is where our lives changed.
Yeah.
Changing in a way of realizing how big we were getting. Like,
yeah, because when we moved in here, we were like, oh yeah, like we do this, like,
it,
yeah,
yeah, it really hit us.
But we didn't realize, like, holy crap, like there's gonna be hundreds of people coming here every single day. Like, we never showed that. Like, we hardly ever showed that. That part of us was like something we always wanted to keep to ourselves, because we felt like the more you show that, the more it feeds fuel to the fire.
Yeah, and
you know, more people are gonna come.
It's like a shout
and
out.
And so, like, this is honestly, like, when I'm here on the street, I just feel so nervous. I feel anxiety because I was literally scared to go out and throw the trash.
Yeah, I think this house definitely was when we realized that we couldn't just leave our house and be normal anymore. Let's show them the backyard. Show them where the kids, we didn't have a lay at the time, but let's show them where Elle used to have a good time. I feel like this house was more alive.
But they had that ramp.
Now that we're not here, I feel like
a little dirt.
It's just here.
And it never felt like home.
Yeah, that's one thing. It never felt like home. But like I've been saying, we were moving into places for our business. It wasn't really for us to be here forever. It wasn't our forever home. It was always an investment. We knew to get to where we wanted to be, we had to be here first.
I don't feel like home. It should be. When that's homey.
Let's say.
Or just in here.
This view.
So. I didn't imagine not having this view. Like, I imagined us being here for a while. I just didn't know we were going to leave so soon. And I didn't know that I was going to end up hating this place as much as I do now.
This view is beautiful. And what we do is so difficult. I feel like people don't understand that there's really nothing private in our lives anymore. Like, as much as we want certain things to be private, it's just not possible because we have to film everything. Like, when we get something new, in order to do what we do, to continue doing what we do, we have to show it.
We have content.
That's content.
We need content, I mean. So, it can be stressful sometimes because, like, we want to feel safe. We want to feel like we're at home. But then we have to film in our home because our home is our office.
Yeah.
Tax write-off.
To keep doing going. What we're doing. Don't keep going. In order for people to
because
have
imagine
to watch.
If like if we don't have anything to show, then there's no content.
Which means Ace Family won't be having any videos. So it's interesting to think about. And I feel like recently we've done a good job of trying to find that balance.
Yeah. We've like strategically found that balance where like we can go on a date and we're not filming and we can feel good about it and still feel like, okay, like tomorrow obviously we're gonna be filming, but we're very strategic about what we film. So it's like, it's really, really tough and it's harder than people think. And if we have the cameras rolling the entire day, if you really think about it, we're never gonna live our lives.
Let's put a GoPro on it.
So over here. Has so many memories. This is where Elle learned how to swing for the first time.
Fire
she used to love this playground. But at the same time, this playground was a curse because as we were swinging, Ace Family members, people would come up to the gate and just be watching us. You know what Elle said to me one day? She goes, Dada, what? And why are they watching me? Yes. And, like, I tried my best not to, like, make it a scene to where, like, they saw us, like, leaving or L noticed or anything. But, like, as they were coming up,
I was like picking her up and like tried to like dip off in the cut.
Abort the mission.
I've never thought about stopping, but I feel like if we...
I've thought about it.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
I have. It can get really stressful at times. Why are you looking at me like that?
Because I didn't think you would ever say that.
Yeah.
She a buck.
Stressful.
She like, she just like face on.
Constantly pleasing people.
Ain't sure.
You know?
Or it's close to a buck, I don't know.
I don't know. And like for the most part, I feel like I'm pretty, like a pretty strong person. Like I don't let things get to me, but I feel like it's just the pressure that like builds up. Cause like the bigger you get, the harder it gets. Like there's been times where I've been so stressed or I'm like, yo, is there like a drug that can like make this shit all go away? Mm. It can get crazy. Like the mental, you gotta really be mentally strong. I feel like to do what we do, consistently do what we do, you know?
Oh my god, he almost cracked.
Hey, we're moving back to your old house.
So you just posted a snap of Alea, now get bashed for it. It's not considered a good thing anymore to get back for whatever reason. People want to see us argue more than us get back.
What is it like being a famous baby?
Acting like you're security. You're lucky I don't beat your ass.
They're back and start saying, like, fucked up shit about our family.
Okay, so that moment right there that you guys saw, and next thing you know, it's a story.
Is that all the problems with the
daughter? I'm tired trying to carry everybody.
So for the safety of our family and our daughters, obviously we have to make some adjustments.
Feel safe? Should we just tell him?
March 2nd. Okay, so from this, I kind of knew majority of what was going on. I was ready for part two to see, like, the juicy details. But I just don't know exactly how I feel about that. Like, I feel like in part one, honestly, and y'all gonna hate me for this, I really don't care at this point. Catherine is still kind of like reserved in the actuality of what she's saying. Like, her natural personality is still like, I don't want to tell the world everything, which is okay. You know what I'm saying? You have the right to do whatever you want to do. But at the same time, it's like, if a documentary is presented to be whole truth, nothing but the truth, and she didn't expect Austin to say, like, yeah, like, this was going on, she like, oh, I didn't expect you to say it. Like, it's okay to say you're about to do something, you know what I'm saying, but you didn't do it, so it's okay. Like, I don't know. That one just, it just threw me off a little bit. Like, and he might be, you feel me, doing a whole sob story for no reason. You never really know, because it's all perception. It's all, you know what I'm saying, your perception is your reality. So however I see this video is how I see it. However y'all see the video is how y'all see it. But I'm just gonna wait for part two. If you are still watching, I appreciate you guys. And if you are new, make sure that you subscribe, like I said before. You know what I'm saying?